I am S. Lakshmi Narayana, school assistant PS, MVNZ PH school, Ondrajuram. Today, I will teach about heat lesson first lesson heat. About heat lesson, you have to understand first. In this chapter, heat always transfer from higher temperature to lower temperature. Heat ane paathyamshamlo, ushnam ane paathyamshamlo, vedi ushnamu adhika ushnagrata nundi alpa ushnagrata vaipu prayanistundi ane concept ganaka mana mind lo unnatlayite, ee chapter lo manam deninaina aakalimpu chesukuntaki veeluga untundi. We can understand easily about this lesson. So what you have to learn first means, you have to understand means, heat always transfer from higher temperature to lower temperature. Heat and what is heat and what is temperature? What is the difference between heat and temperature? Ushnamu ushnagrata. Rendu madhya theda enti? Heat always transfer from higher temperature to lower temperature, already we you announced it. Up to where the temperature transfer? This ushnamu adhika ushnagrata nundi alpa ushnagrata enta varaku prayanistundi ante, both objects must be equal in temperature, then there is no transfer of heat from one substance to other substance. అంటే హీట్ ఉష్ణము అధిక ఉష్ణోగ్రత ఉన్నటువంటి వస్తువు నుండి అల్ప ఉష్ణోగ్రత వస్తువుకి వెళ్ళేటప్పుడు ఎంతవరకు అది ప్రయాణిస్తుంది అంటే ఆ రెండు వస్తువుల యొక్క ఉష్ణోగ్రత సమానం అయ్యేంతవరకు మాత్రమే ప్రయాణిస్తుంది. దట్ వెన్ దోస్ టూ ఆబ్జెక్ట్స్ ఆర్ ఈక్వల్ అట్ దట్ టెంపరేచర్ వీ కెన్ సే థర్మల్ ఈక్విలిబ్రియం. దాన్ని మనం థర్మల్ ఈక్విలిబ్రియం అంటాం. We can say heat means, heat is a energy transist from one object to other object. What is temperature means? At equal thermal equilibrium, the temperature of the heat, the temperature of the object, at it is in thermal equilibrium, we can say that is a temperature. అంటే థర్మల్ ఈక్విలిబ్రియంగా ఉన్నప్పుడు మాత్రమే ఆ వస్తువు యొక్క ఉష్ణోగ్రతని ఉష్ణాన్ని అమౌంట్ ఆఫ్ హీట్ని టెంపరేచర్ అంట. ముఖ్యంగా వాట్ ఈజ్ కోల్డ్ అండ్ హాట్? వెన్ యు ఆర్ టచింగ్ ఎన్ ఆబ్జెక్ట్ వీ కెన్ సే దిస్ ఆబ్జెక్ట్ ఈజ్ ఎ హాట్ బాడీ ఆర్ కోల్డ్ బాడీ. ఇది హాట్గా ఉంది, ఇది కోల్డ్గా ఉంది, చల్లగా ఉంది, ఇది వేడిగా ఉందని హౌ కెన్ వీ సే? మనం ఎలా చెప్పగలుగుతున్నాం? ఫర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ వితౌట్ బై టచింగ్ ఇన్ దిస్ ఆబ్జెక్ట్ వీఆర్ సేయింగ్ దిస్ ఆబ్జెక్ట్ ఈజ్ ఏ కోల్డ్, అదర్వైజ్ ఇట్ ఈజ్ ఏ హాట్ బాడీ. హౌ యు ఆర్ సేయింగ్ బై టచింగ్? దట్ మీన్స్ ఆల్రెడీ ఐ అనౌన్స్డ్ యూ హీట్ ఈజ్ ఆల్వేజ్ ట్రాన్స్ఫర్. ఇన్ ద సేమ్ వే here also heat is transferred from one object to another object. That means if it is a cold means, how we are saying a cold means, our temperature, our body temperature is more than the temperature of this object, then what will happen? The heat is transferred from our body to this object. That means we are losing heat. That's why you are telling it is a cold. In the same way, when you are touching an hot object, we are saying it is hot. That means the object's temperature is more than our body temperature. That's why the heat is transferred from hot body to our body. That's why you are getting more heat. That's why you are telling it is a hot body. So by touching how you are saying means the same principle, heat is always transferred from one object to other object. If the heat is transferred from our body to other object means it is a cold object. If the heat is transferred from other object to our body means it is a hot body. We can say like the given object is cold or hot, we can easily say. Next, specific heat. For example, Q is the amount of heat. Let Q is the amount of heat I absorbed or lost when we are thinking. For example, manu edana enta amount of heat ni mana absorb chesemo లేదా ఎంత అమౌంట్ ఆఫ్ హీట్ని లూజ్ చేసామో అనేది ఇట్ ఈజ్ డిపెండ్ అపాన్ ఆబ్జెక్ట్ మాస్ ఆఫ్ ద ఆబ్జెక్ట్ డిఫరెన్స్ ఆఫ్ ద ఆబ్జెక్ట్ టెంపరేచర్ డెల్టా టీ సో ఇట్ ఈజ్ ప్యూర్లీ డిపెండ్ అపాన్ మాస్ ఆఫ్ ద ఆబ్జెక్ట్ ఎం అండ్ డిఫరెన్స్ ఆఫ్ ద టెంపరేచర్ డెల్టా టీ దట్ మీన్స్ క్యూ ఈజ్ If the mass is more, it absorbs more heat. If the mass is less, it absorbs less heat. So we can say Q is directly proportional to M. Q is directly proportional to M means if the mass of the object is more means it absorbs more heat. If the mass of the object is less means it absorbs less heat. So it is directly proportional. In the same way, if the temperature from lower temperature to get higher temperature, it must absorb more heat. If the difference is 10 degrees C, when you are comparing with the difference of 30 degrees C, that means to raise the temperature or decrease the temperature. To raise the temperature means it absorbs the heat. To decrease the heat temperature means it loses some heat by absorb or losing. So difference of temperature is also directly proportional to the quantity of heat. So to raise the temperature 10 degrees C, it absorbs less heat. To raise the difference of 30 degrees temperature, it absorbs more heat. That's why Q is also directly proportional to delta T. Delta T means difference in temperature. So from these two, we can say Q is directly proportional to M delta T, the product of mass and difference in temperature. So we can equalize this directly proportional. Q is equal to some constant. That constant is here S denoted. S is nothing but specific heat. So S into M delta T. We can say this is MS delta T. So Q is equal to, we can say the formula Q is equal to MS delta T. What is meant by Q? Q is amount of heat absorbed or lost or lose. What is the M? The mass of the substance. S is a specific heat. We can say about a specific heat later. Delta T is the difference in temperature. Difference in temperature means, for example, we are heating an object from 10 degrees to 30 degrees means. What is the difference from 10 to 30? 30 minus 10, 20 degrees C. So that is the, we can say, for example, object's temperature is T1 now. When you are eating this object, at last it gets T2. What is the difference means? T2 minus T1. Why T2 minus T1 means? After getting the temperature, it is T2. Initial temperature is T1. So difference amount of heat, how much raised means, we can say T2 minus T1. So what is S? Specific heat. Specific heat also we can say S is equal to, now we can say from this equation S is equal to Q, here M is multiplying, if it is comes to in this equation left side it divides, so Q by M into delta T, that is the S, specific heat. So specific heat means we can say amount of heat to required to raise 1 degree C temperature to 1 gram of object. 1 gram of object ni oka degree C raise cheyadaniki entaithe heat ni manam teeskuntunamo teeskuntundo aa object aa temperature ni aa object yokka specific heat antam. Specific heat means amount of heat required to raise 1 degree C temperature of 1 gram of substance. And ఎంత 1 gram more, not less, not more than 1 gram or not less than 1 gram. We can say 1 unit of substance also we can say 1 unit gram. 1 unit of a substance to raise 1 degree C temperature, how much amount of heat is requiring? That required amount is nothing but specific heat of a that substance. So all specific, all objects specific heat is the same means we cannot say. Different substances absorbs different temperatures, so specific heat also different, materials specific heat also different. So mainly specific heat means to raise 1 degree temperature of a 1 gram of a substance, how much amount of heat is, that substance is requiring, that amount of heat is nothing but specific heat. Next, specific heat, the SI unit in this heat temperature and specific heat. For example, heat, the SI unit of heat is joules. For in CGS unit is calorie. SI unit is, we can say SI unit also MKS system. Systems MKS and MKS system we can say as SI unit also. Next CGS. In SI unit the heat unit is joule, and in CGS it is a calorie. 1 calorie is equal to 1 calorie is equal to 4.186 joules. 1 calorie is equal to 4.186 joules. Next, temperature. Temperature units also we can say in SI unit Kelvin. In SI unit, these are the heat, for heat, for heat. In temperature, SI unit is Kelvin. Kelvin. Kelvin means 0 degree C is equal to 273 Kelvin. 0 degree C is equal to 273 K. In Celsius, 0 degree C equal to 273 K. In the same way, how 10 degree C, how much means 0 degree C is 273. 10 degree C means 273 K plus 10 That means 283K. That means for in Celsius, if the reading is given, means we can change into Kelvin by adding 273 simply. Then we will get the Kelvin temperature. If Kelvin temperature is given, means to convert into Celsius degrees, you must subtract 273 from Kelvin, we will get Celsius degrees. To Celsius to Kelvin means, for Celsius you have to add 273, then we will get a Kelvin temperature. If Kelvin temperature is given, means to change into Celsius, from Kelvin you have to subtract 273, then we will get Celsius degrees. So next, simply discuss about kinetic energy in temperatures. What is the kinetic energy and the potential energy when you are observing? If it is a cold, for example, when you are taking a tumbler of water, in that water molecules, if it is in rest position, the water molecules have energy, potential energy. While you are heating that water molecules are absorbing heat and it is moving. Moving means moving particles exerts energy, kinetic energy. The kinetic energy is more when you are heating. If the temperature is more, the kinetic energy is more. If the temperature is less, the kinetic energy is decreasing and potential energy is increasing. If the kinetic energy is increasing, means the potential energy is decreasing. At any molecule, the potential energy and the kinetic energy is always same. If the temperature is more, means potential energy is less and kinetic energy is more. If the temperature is less, means potential energy may be more and the kinetic energy is less. At whatever the temperature, the total potential energy and kinetic energy is the same. So we can discuss the remaining subject in later class. Thank you all.